Hi, I'm Michael Strong. Good to be back with you. Now, I want to have you take a look at this handsome young couple over here. That's me and my beautiful wife, Carla, 30 years ago on our wedding day. Now, the good news is the marriage is going strong, but unfortunately, our wedding album is falling apart. Literally, it's just come apart at the seams. You can see that something needs to be done. So we decided to redo the album scrapbook style. And today I'm going to take you along to show you chapter one, page one of the whole new album. So the main decorative element on the page is actually a dogwood flower. It's kind of a big dramatic flower. It's one of the projects from my book, Paper Greenhouse. And Paper Greenhouse really is just a paper crafting book. And you take regular paper that you might have around the house or cardstock, very simple things, paper, scissors, glue, ink, very easy things to use. And you can make these pretty realistic looking flowers. Now, Carla chose for our page a dogwood flower because, for one thing, it's white and it goes with the theme. And also, it's a flat flower, so when we close the album, it won't damage that element of the page. We're gonna start with white cardstock. It's just your regular type of cardstock you would find. This is about 80 pound cardstock. So I cut it on the paper cutter so that I have a 4 1/4 by 11 inch piece, and I folded it in half. And we're going to cut the petals for the blossom out of this folded piece. Now to begin with, you're gonna have to kind of experiment with your artistic skills and draw what I'll call the template, the first blossom petal. And what you're going for is kind of a chubby teardrop. So you'll cut one out, get one that you like, and it should be about 2 inches from top to bottom. So I'm going to draw it again on this other folded piece that I have. So you just put it on the fold and trace around it. And what you'll get are 4 identical petals. So after these are all cut out, what you'll have is 1, 2, 3, and 4 petals. Now we've got to have a base to glue them to. And what I use is a 1 1/2 inch square of cardstock. And I'm just going to draw across right down the center of it. And then I'm going to cut out 4 corners of it. Basically what I'm going to end up with is kind of a cross. We're going to attach the petals to this base. Now before I glue this to the base, we need to do a little treatment to these petals to give it that characteristic wrinkle that you see on the petals of a dogwood flower. Now I'm using a mouse pad. You could use, if you didn't have a mouse pad, you could use just a pile of newspaper, something that will give you a little cushion underneath. And I went to my toolbox and I found this tool. It's actually for putting window screening into windows, but I found that it works really good for this. And all I'm doing is rolling it along, and you'll see that it's making grooves right in the petal. I'm doing that on all the sides like this. I'll do that to all 4 of them, and then I'm going to glue them to the base. Just use a little white glue, put it right on, and start with the point of the petal right at the center of the cross. And that's your basic dogwood flower. The only other thing that I want to tell you about dogwoods is they have those little spots on the ends that give it that characteristic look. And for that, I'm using the Ranger ink. It's the Nick Bantock collection, the Van Dyke brown. It's a really nice deep brown. I always use this brown. It's one of my favorite colors. And what we're going to do is just take the pencil eraser and dip it into your ink pad and put a little spot right at the tip top corner here on each of the petals. You can see how that's starting to look more like a dogwood now. And what I also want to do is give it a little nip with some hand punch here. This is another typical characteristic of this flower. All right, so what I'm gonna do is set this aside now and start working on the leaves. Now the leaves I did with kind of an olive green color, and it's just cardstock like we used before. The only thing I did to it was treat it with some more of this Nick Bantock ink. This time I'm using the chartreuse leaf. Now, I saw Bethany use this on one of her segments, and I really like this color. It's a nice, deep, rich green. And all you have to do is just ink the paper leave some of the natural paper color showing through. After it's been inked, you can fold this right in half, and you could use the same template that I used for the blossom. So once again, put them on and draw around the template, and you'll be cutting those out. You'll need 3 for the flower and 1 for a little decorative element later. So you'll see how we cut these out. But before I attach it to the blossom, I'm going to add some veins to the leaf. That's simply done with a colored pencil, a pale yellow colored pencil. And the process is pretty simple. You're just going to draw a line right through the center, and then 3 other lines, and they're kind of like arcs. There's 1, there's 2, there's 3. And then you repeat that on the other side. 1, 2, 3. And then we're going to add a couple of little veins off of the main ones. This gives it a nice, more realistic look. So there's 1, and I like to use about 3 leaves, and I want to show you how to attach those. You're just putting them on the back with some regular tape that you can just attach them with. I'm using 3 on the other side. So this is how it looks. We're going to work on the stems next. And for that, I'm using some kind of terracotta color paper, which I've inked using the Nick Bantock brown again. And as you can see, I just kind of rubbed it on, leaving some of that paper show underneath. Then I cut it into 2-inch strips, and then we're folding that in half. But this time what we're going to do is cut off a very small part of it, and it's just the spine, just where the paper is folded. And what this gives you is a nice, strong, almost wooden-like stem. Now I've done some before, and I want to show you that those are going to be attached also with some tape. So you'll have 3 little stems. Turn it over, place them on the flower, and then just tape them down. And that's the stem portion. All right, then the last part is the center of the flower. Now, this is a kind of a goofy thing, but I think you'll probably enjoy making it. What I did was I used regular paper towels that you might have in your house to make these little spit wads, that's what I call them. But they're going to form the center of the flower. And what I did, I used the Nick Bantock inks again, only this time it's the chrome yellow. It's really a nice bright yellow. And I inked both sides of the paper towel. And to get these little pieces, all you have to do is pinch off little pieces like that. I'm thinking fingernail-sized pieces or thumbnail-sized pieces, about this big. All you have to do is get a little glue, put it on the paper, and just wad it up. Put it in the center of the palm of your hand and start rolling it. That's why I call it a spit wad. So you'll get 7 of these to make the center of the flower. Now these have already dried because I made them a little earlier. Put some white glue right in the center of the flower and arrange those in a circle. To do the arranging, I actually like to use my craft knife. It's the crafter's everything tool. This is simplicity personified, really. Usually on my pages, there's a lot going on, you know. But this time, I'm just using a single picture as the focal point of this page. This is the one I chose. It's from our wedding album. I decided to play with scale on this picture. I'm going to use the picture as the focal point, but I'm also going to use it as a background. And for that, I put it into my scanner and scanned it, and then with the computer program, I brightened up the picture. You can see how much brighter it looks than the original has faded. But then I also blew up the picture and toned down the colors quite a bit to make more of a muted background, and I cropped that and layered it on top of 2 mats. So this is basically the arrangement with the 2 pictures and then the flower that comes in and covers Carla's bouquet there. The last element of the page is the title, and I found these really great peel-off letters from SEI, and again I'm using my craft knife as a tool, and what I'm going to do is peel off some of these letters, and I use my ruler as a base, and then by using this knife instead of fingers, you can really position your letters very well. Now for the bottom of this, I'm putting the date of our marriage. It's August 21st, 1976. Wow, I remember it. And I'm starting with the six. That's the last letter in the line because I want to know where I'm ending this line, and I want it to end right under the focal point of the picture. So you can kind of put it in place like that. I did the same thing as you can see on the finished page at the top with our names. So I wanted the names above our heads. So there's Carla and Mike. So I started with the word and I put it between us. And then I used the stickers for my name on this side. And then I worked backwards for Carla's name on that side. Now you can use my book to make other things too. And I brought a kind of an array of the cards that I used. Here's the dogwood in a card form. There's another one that I think would be great for scrapbooking, which is English ivy. It looks really nice around old photographs. That's a nice one. So I hope it doesn't take me 30 years to finish this thing, but I'll give you progress reports next time I come. So I had a great time today. I hope you did too, and I'll see you again soon.
For step-by-step instructions on how to create this week's project, download the design guide featuring special make-it-your-own bonus tips.